Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is V. I am an actuary and currently living in Canada. My channel mission is to help you study smarter, work better, and live happier. So one of my objectives is to promote career related to math, data, and our coding. So this is another episode of Careers in Math, Get to Know a Professional. And I am very excited to introduce you to another career path for those who study math or interested in careers in investment or quantitative finance. Hi, Minh. Thanks for being here today. So can you share with us a little bit about yourself?
Pleasure to be here today as well. So a bit about myself. So I'm actually working as a quant analyst at Westpac, one of the big four banks in Australia. I've been in Sydney for more than 10 years, and after my CFA and a bit of a couple of years working in the investment industry, so I decided to change my career to more quant oriented. So that's roughly the story and about myself. So I love reading technical books, play a bit of classical music, and I also spend a lot of time on playing computer games. So yeah.
So what led you to pursue a career in finance?
Back in high school, I did a lot of math and programming. And if you're actually good at the stuff in the country at the time, then basically you can do almost everything. But then I didn't like any of the careers in math or either programming. So my dad actually made decisions for me to study business and finance. And the good thing is it turned out that I just loved it. So I got along with finance and business really, really well. So after uni, I decided to go further with that. So I took my CFA program and I got a really good job in one of the largest superannuation funds in Australia. And I stayed in the same job for 5 years.
I can see that parents usually have great influence on their children's career choices. And I guess it makes sense at the beginning, especially when you're not sure what you like. So can you share with us a little bit more about your professional path up to now?
When I first started out, when I finished uni, I had my internship working in a private equity fund. So basically, your job is to look at venture capital, building financial models using Excel and prepare presentation on PowerPoint. So I got that one for 20 months, and then my first year I spent at this small financial planning firm. So internship in private capital, and then the first year in my career I spent in financial planning, giving advice, financial advice to clients who need statement of advice, who want to buy insurance or set up their superannuation fund, or it is really, really high level of like selling financial products to clients in need. And then, so after 1 year, I decided, okay, so maybe I wanted to do more analytical sort of work. So I decided to take my CFA level one at the time. So I passed that one, searched for a job, and then got a job as an analyst in a superannuation fund. And I took level two and three afterward. And then I've been working in superannuation fund since 2015 until recently. I moved into Westpac as a quant. Yep.
So you previously worked in investment and now in quant. Can you tell us more about your roles and responsibility or how your typical day or week look like?
And much of the time at Westpac, yeah. So let's actually talk about my previous role as a portfolio analyst, and then we moved into quant analyst as well. So as a portfolio analyst, as a big multi-asset fund, so especially working in asset allocation, so you look at various things like, of course, things like daily market movement. And then you have a portfolio actually built based on valuation signal. You look at how market's performing and how expensive, how cheap they are. You decide to how much capital you want to allocate into your portfolios. You also perform things like stress testing or look at the risk analytics of the portfolio to see what sort of risk your portfolios have exposure to. And then you also use derivatives to rebalance or speculate, make any alpha gain on your portfolio. So that's very investment centric in the previous role. And then when I moved to Westpac as a quant, so the web is actually completely different. So I work in market risk analytics. So basically we have a front office team. So they make all sorts of trading and financial products that they want. And the people in the middle office or risk management team have a job to understand those products, how to price them, validate the models and manage the risk of those things in the banking book. So so the day-to-day jobs would involve a lot about, involve a lot of model validations, calculating the P&L of the derivative positions, a lot of coding in either Python or R. I would say most of the time that we spend on coding and try to get output from one system to the other system and get them to communicate with each other, understand the output, and then split out the number so that people could understand and gauge the level of risk of a position or a particular derivative trade.
So how do you like your previous role compared to your current role?
So there's a lot of great things about previous role, right? So it's, when you first started out, it's really, I guess it depends on the perspective of the person as well. So some want to have really dirty hands, like to do the stuff at low level, detail level. Super fund is, on the other hand, is more like fund of fund structure. So you don't really do the, you don't actually handpick the investment, right? But at the same time, you have an overview of almost everything in the industry. So super fund, you have exposure to property, infrastructure, private capital, fixed income, equity, currency, and also investment there. So you have a very good understanding of how the industry works and what sort of investment people actually make and how they construct their portfolio. So it's excellent for you to understand that from the point of view of a portfolio managers and how things should be run and what kind of investment strategy that you can make and a bunch of systems that you can learn on how to use them. So a lot of valuable knowledge transferred to you. But then at the same time, by the end of the day, you also want to have kind of more, get your hands dirty on how actually we pick the stock, how we actually make the trade there, so what system that we use, so what numbers we actually key into the system so that the people in the middle of this could understand. So that's sort of a question like a why, but I was always curious about how a derivative contract actually priced and managed in terms of risk. So I decided to take a master of quant finance in 2018, and I was in love with that one. So I guess it just more suited to my nature. Lots of programming and math involved. So, and then after 2 years, I decided, okay, maybe it's time for me to give it a go. So then I stopped working in the investment industry. So I guess I consider that as a break from this industry and then move into the quant one.
So getting a master in quantitative finance helped you to move into more quant role. Let's talk about the designation Chartered Financial Analyst. So is CFA a must for those who are interested in a finance job?
Okay, so when we say my career path, well, let's say that the career path without the quant finance is just, like the finance and quant finance are very different areas, I would say, up until this point. So if I would have stick to my career in investment, right? So what my observation is, people tend to see CFA as a minimum requirement rather than something that they acquire along their career path, because the reality is that younger and younger people are actually taking CFA exams. So last week I saw a guy on my LinkedIn got his CFA fully awarded charter holder at the age of 22. So he was probably the youngest guy ever, well, probably one of the youngest guys. And usually people would pick candidates to give them interview with the level one and level two path. So it's more like become an industry norm that you should have or you must have a CFA to get into the front door. Mm-hmm. And then from that, you can move upward and do whatever you want to do. But to get that interview, because basically like after uni, right, you have no experience, no advantage, no skill. So what else people could look at? So they look at CFA and say, oh, this guy, he passed level one, he passed level two. So maybe we should give him the chance to interview. So I see that as more like a norm in the industry that people must have CFA to get the role. But then at the same time, I did not use it a lot. So it's more like you need it for the sake of having it. And that's a requirement of it. It's just like everyone must have a bachelor degree or a master degree to do a certain type of job, but they don't ever use anything from their degree to actually do the work. So I guess that's more like what I see. And also, they tend to hire more and more people with engineering and starting background as well. So recently, my old fund, they hire a lot of like engineering graduates and people with math background. So they could do programming and a lot of fancy stuff in there that normal finance people couldn't do. So, yep.
Then you would say like a master in quantitative finance is a must, or what type of education would be required?
Right, so good question. So when I first got admitted into the course, the master quant finance course, they didn't even consider the fact that the candidate had a CFA or not. So if you talk to the academics in the quant finance area, right, so they wouldn't even think about that as a requirement. To be honest, they don't really care. So they care about people who actually had a math background, have an engineering background, physics background, science background, so STEM basically, computer science as well. So it's to them, it's not relevant because the finance bit is actually the, from their perspective, the finance bit is the bit that they can easily train. The hard bit is the programming and the math one, and they need people on that side to understand like all the fancy stochastic calculus and measure theory and things. But the finance part, like how the contract is priced or its structure, then it's more like they can learn on the spot. And that's what they see and perceive. Also in reality, that's what a lot of funds seeing people as well. So they hire engineering students to come on board and they just learn how a contract is priced or how a trading strategy works right on the spot, rather than looking for people with a finance background. So that's why I would say it's not relevant if you need a CFA in quant finance. It's more like you need good background in math, engineering, computer science, or physics, or usually. So the story in Westpac, right, so where I work right now, I was actually the only guy who had a business background. So everyone else in the team, they had either PhD in science, math, physics or something, or they have computer science and engineering background. So I was the only guy with this background.
Last but not least, if you can give an advice to your younger self, what would you say?
About career, I think it's one of my biggest regrets. I didn't do more math, and I spent a lot of time doing business stuff and like accounting and financing. So if I could give advice to my younger self about education, the right education to do, I definitely would recommend myself to do more science subjects or things. So that kind of train your ability to think, and that gives you a lot more skill, well, rather than just presentation and Excel and PowerPoint. Not saying that those are not important, but those can be learned at the later stage easier than the things like programming, like, which you have to learn like, at the early stage like, to be good at it. So that's about education, about life, and I would say probably study a little bit less and do something else. So I'm not recommending people to be lazy and party throughout their uni, but just saying I think I spent too much time doing that, so I probably should do less of that and then enjoy life a bit more. Probably do something like painting or, you know, great stuff like ice skating, for example. Yeah, so, or bodybuilding, so yeah, that's even better.
So there you go, another episode of Career in Math, Get to Know the Professional. And I hope you understand a little more about the possibilities for careers in investment or quant, and especially understand a little bit more about the job of a portfolio analyst or a quantitative analyst. And if you find this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe if you're not already done so. And I will see you in next video. Bye!